Go to waste. Do not work. Thanks. a soul in tune to the savage desire for a soulmate. Hey, it's a savage desire for a soul untamed. Well, the feeling of the cry in the present day. Ruffle my clothes in the fire. Ruffle my horse in the fire. And those things grow, and the fire will burn just to keep me confined. But you still show me a way. But you still show me a light. Cause I was only a kid when I found your top to me aside.
Hello, AV Club. I'm Abe. We got Dave here from Gang of Youth.
Hey.
How's it going?
I'm really well. I love Chicago. And we've only been here for an hour.
Wow.
Is that right? Yeah.
What is it about Chicago?
Our keyboardist guitarist is from here and he hasn't been back in 11 years.
So welcome back, keyboardist guitarist.
Sentimental as fuck.
You got some other local Chicago friends with Whitney, right?
Yeah. We went on a festival tour in Australia called Lameway, which is possibly the funnest thing we've ever done. And we got to know Whitney pretty well on that tour.
Good dudes.
Yeah, the best dudes.
Awesome.
Really, yeah, it's super, super odd. Odd people. In like a highly respectable way.
Well, I feel like in every TV show I've watched lately, there's always a scene where it's like, it's cool to be weird. It's good to be odd.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting, the commodification of strangeness.
Word.
You know, where was that when we were teenagers? You
know, I know. Why didn't we get to cash in on that?
Fuck yeah, dude.
What's the best Halloween costume you've ever had?
I went as Dave LaPepe from Gang of Youth.
Yeah.
Good one. Yeah, it was a good one.
Cool. Do you guys celebrate Halloween much?
No, not really. We don't really do it in Australia.
Is that true?
It's the one thing we don't really do. I mean, it's become something more recently, primarily because of the influence of, you know, US culture. But none of us really do it. And my parents were hella religious growing up, so they tried to forbid it. I think next year I'm going to go as Gal from Gorgoroth.
Cool.
Yeah, with corpse paint and shit. Yeah. Well, he's now in Godseed. So Gala from Godseed.
Okay, next
that's
year.
That's my answer. Yeah, next
TBD.
Year. Yeah. I don't know what it is that's made it so relevant. I think it might have been the influx of like a lot of American culture, which is cool. None of us really, do you guys ever celebrate it? No. Because no one really goes trick-or-treating. It's kind of a weird thing in Australia to like knock on someone's door and be like, hi, give me shit. Yeah.
It's a weird thing anyway. Not like the
isn't that fucking weird. Strange? That's
and then every other day of the year, you're like forbidden from asking people for candy.
Yeah, it's like, it's the one day of the year where kids are encouraged to ask strangers for candy.
It's wrong.
Fucking super wrong.
We should denounce it. I want to denounce it after this year, after because you got a costume in mind and because I want to... I put a reminder in my phone a couple days ago to remind me come Halloween time to go as a yoga mat this year and just like cut a hole in a yoga mat and put it around my shoulders.
I saw the best one. Someone went as... The human centipede.
One person?
Yeah, but they had like paper mache fucking people behind him.
That's incredible. That's
worth vulgar as hell.
What's your favorite swear word?
Well, being Australian, I think you know what my favorite swear word is.
Tell me.
Bush. No. No, we like cunt in Australia. Everyone says cunt. It's misogynistic to some and liberating for others. So it's the kind of word that even has like enormous linguistic and political connotations, which is I think why it's such a fascinating fucking word. It's a step above fuck.
True.
Like how can you go above fuck with cunt?
Lastly, what do you want to promote?
We're releasing our record, a second album called Go Father in Lightness, hopefully to rapturous acclaim but likely to nobody and no attention whatsoever. So that's what we're doing, and we're touring at the moment. And if you haven't heard of us before, we released an album in 2015 called The Positions, and it was about this relationship I was in with a girl who had cancer.
I'm absolutely sure you will get that rapturous acclaim that you're not expecting. Dave, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you for letting me sit with you and stare into this blue hair of yours. Pleasure to meet you. You guys killed it today.
Thanks so much, man.
And goodbye, everybody.
Bye, Avid Club.